I'm Steve Lauer, and I'm a biostatistics researcher at for the Reich Lab at UMass Public Health. So our research is about tracking the spread of dengue fever in Thailand and trying to predict where dengue will come up next. So I'm from Sudbury, Massachusetts, which is a suburb of Boston. And my mother was a nurse, and my dad was an engineer. And that sounds like it would just be, you know, nurse plus engineer equals biostatistician. Seems pretty simple, but, you know, I kind of took a long way around that. Even when I was, you know, 9 or 10 years old, I would keep these Excel spreadsheets of all the Boston Red Sox players' statistics, or, you know, Celtics and the Patriots. They were my favorite teams, being from Boston. I actually worked in sports media as an undergrad, and I had to write down all the statistics for volleyball and water polo and I think men's basketball and some other ones. It's great. People have a huge amount of passion for sports. I'm glad that I have a passion for sports and for public health. I wish more people had a passion for public health as well. This is my office. Biostatistics is really statistics for public health. So some projects that I personally have worked on have been an influenza project where we're trying to figure out when should hospitals open up more rooms to account for the flu season. But it can be in infectious diseases, or it could be for cancer, and be for treatments, vaccines, you name it. And we work with the Thai Ministry of Public Health, and every 2 weeks they send us case counts for the country and the different provinces and where dengue fever is coming up. And we take in those counts and we look at that and weather data, and we try to predict for the next 2 weeks, month, 6 months, how much dengue is there going to be, where is it going to be. It's very difficult to predict this disease. It has a lot of biological mechanisms that are difficult to trace, but we're trying to use what we know about the disease and new statistical techniques to make better predictions and supply them directly to the Ministry of Public Health so that they can make policy decisions and hopefully stem epidemics before they even happen. So when I finish grad school, I think there will be several roads open to me, but I think it would be great to work for someplace like the CDC, the Center for Disease Control, or National Institutes of Health, because they are like the health departments of America, where they have these resources, they have the data that I need to, you know, analyze and hopefully make interesting insights, and also they have the tools to implement those and to inform the public directly of my research, and I think that that would be the best utilization of my skills. So before I got into graduate school, I actually lived in China for 2 years teaching English, and I had been accepted to this biostatistics program, and they told me, go see the world, go absorb as much as you can before you come back here, and it will help you, and I think it has. I've always been a kind of people person, somebody who I try to look to help others. I just never realized that I could do it with statistics. There are interesting challenges, and you realize how much progress people have made, especially in the last 5 or 10 years, and you're just trying to forge new ground and build upon what others have taught you, and I think that that idea of both creating new methods, applying them to new situations, is exciting, and then the fact that those can then be used to help people in the real world, all around the world, is fantastic.